Welcome to my channel. This is my first video. I am a little awkward though. You guys, I just filmed the first video that is going up on my YouTube channel. If you guys are watching, you are witnessing my first ever YouTube video. I have been wanting to start a YouTube channel for over 5 years now. I don't know why I haven't done it. Maybe scared to just put myself out there. I just kept making excuses about why I couldn't do it. Maybe why people wouldn't watch me. And you know what? I figure life is too short. Go do what you want to do. And that's what I'm doing. I'm just doing what I want to do. One of the big reasons that I decided to start my channel is because I was starting to feel like there wasn't anybody out there who I was relating to. Nobody was relatable anymore. Everyone is now in this level of perfection. I like seeing people with flaws. I like seeing people with personality. And I just felt like I could be that for people. I'm just like the everyday gal. I get breakouts on my face. I have red skin. I'm not perfect. I don't want to pretend to be perfect. And honestly, nobody is perfect. Like, we're all imperfectly perfect. Yeah, I just thought this would be a fun little hobby for me to do. And if it leads to something, great. If it doesn't, I just want to do it for fun. I feel like I just really need something in my life right now that makes me happy, that just makes me excited again. So I just want to say thank you for being here. I hope that you stay. Please subscribe. If you do subscribe, please leave a comment down below because I would like to track my first like 100 subscribers. So if I do continue with this, I can look back in a few years and be like, hey, there's Tracy. She was my number 70 subscriber. She's been around here since I started. And I thought that would be just like a fun little thing. I don't know. I hope you guys are excited because I am really excited. I just really need something new. I work in a place where I can't wear makeup. I wear the bare minimum, a little bit of light foundation, concealer, that's it. My hair's back in a bun. That's all I can do. So I need somewhere where I can play with makeup. So in today's video, I'm going to be doing a full face of ColourPop cosmetics. There are a couple products that I don't have, like the primer, setting spray, brows, and powder. The reason I don't have the setting spray and the primer is because they were a matte formula, and I have really dry skin, so I just didn't see the point in grabbing those items. The rest of it is all ColourPop. Some of these are first impressions, and some of these are like my all-time favorite ColourPop items. I thought this would be a great first video because ColourPop is my favorite brand. I love that they are affordable. A lot of ColourPop items are actually more affordable than drugstore nowadays. I just thought this would be a fun video to kick off my channel, just talking about stuff I'm really passionate about, makeup that's affordable. If you're excited for this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and leave a comment down below telling me that you subscribe so I can give you your subscriber number. If you are not following me on Instagram, make sure you do. All the products that I have used will be listed down below. If you want to see how I got this makeup look, then just keep watching. Today we're going to be doing a full face of ColourPop cosmetics. I just got a bunch of new stuff in. I got this cute little extra package and it says, sorry, we're late. And it is an ultra glossy lip in the shade Atta Girl. I didn't feel like my order was late or anything, but I appreciate a free gift. That is awesome. Since I didn't grab a primer, I'm just gonna go in with my two normal ones. I put this one on my face to hydrate it, and then I use this one to fill in my pores. So I picked up the No Filter Foundation Stick in the shade Light 40N for my face. And I picked up one for like a cream contour in the shade Medium Dark 147. I ordered these shades online, so I'm not sure how they're gonna look. Ooh, that's pretty sturdy feeling. That feels good quality. Ooh, this looks a little peach for me. Let's do a little test. Not as bad as I thought. Nice. Now I do just want to peek at this shade. Ooh, that is very orange. I feel like something I don't like about the ColourPop website is that their swatches generally don't look like what you get in person. So it's usually best to go look online, either on YouTube or just swatches in general to see about a shade match. Let's, no, I'm not putting that all over my face. So I've never used this. I'm not really sure how much to use. Let's just swipe. That feels very creamy. I don't think this color match is gonna be too bad. A little bit yellow for me. Okay, let's do half of the face just so we can see kind of what it looks like. And I'm gonna blend that out with just a BS Mall brush. This is from an inexpensive Amazon kit. Usually stick foundations blend out better for me with a brush. Blending out really easily. Oh yeah, not a bad color match at all. Yes! Yes! That makes me excited. Stupid. That was stupid. Very stupid. I got little fuzzies on it. Almost like a Jaclyn Cosmetics lipstick. This looks like I don't really have anything on, which I do like. It is definitely tacky. So I'm gonna go ahead and go in on this side, which as you can see is my problem side. Having a little bit of issues right now. But it's okay, because we all break out. We all get pimples every now and then. Not a big deal. See how well this covers. Yeah, cover that up, cover that up. Originally thought this was going to be a lot more stiff, so I am pleasantly surprised at how creamy this is. Did a pretty good job. I would say right now it's looking about medium coverage. I do kind of want to see if we can build this up, so we're going to go in just a little bit more. Let's go in again with another layer. Okay, just upon first impression, I don't think I would layer that just because it is kind of looking a little bit heavy on my forehead, around my nose. I do think it built up a little bit. I wouldn't say it's like way more coverage, so I'm not sure it's worth it to have it look kind of cakey and heavy. So I would just say go in with one layer of this, and it's definitely still feeling really creamy. Which I'm okay with because I was scared it was gonna be a really matte formula, so I am okay with that. And I don't think that's looking too bad. So I do already have the ColourPop No Filter Concealer, and I have mine in the shade Fair 08. This is too light for me, and it's also a little too matte for me. I do think this is a great concealer, and I do use this every day, but I do mix it with the Flower Beauty Light Illusions Concealer. This one is almost too creamy, and together they make a good match. I'm just gonna go in with a little bit there. So usually I lay this one down first, and then I do put this right in that deepest corner where all the darkness is, typically by my nose, a little on my chin. As I'm getting older, I'm seeing more lines on my face, and that means more product is sinking into those lines, and it doesn't look very flattering. So I'm kind of learning how to do my makeup over again and finding new techniques that don't exaggerate those lines. So I'm just gonna take this brush and blend it out. And the ColourPop concealer does dry down really fast, so you wanna work pretty fast with it. When I use it with the Flower Beauty concealer though, it helps it to be more emollient and not dry down as fast. Okay, and I'm just gonna tap this out really lightly. Ooh, okay. This foundation is too tacky for that. Normally I'll go around the cakier spots with my finger to kind of take away the cakiness, but I'm scared this is gonna lift up. Let's give it a try. That worked really well around my nose. Let's try up here. Okay, that's working just fine. Cool, okay. I think it was just that concealer didn't really mix well together. This foundation is still really creamy and really tacky. Scared this is gonna be really orange, but let's give it a whirl. Definitely too warm for me. Like I said, this is a really creamy formula, so I think it is gonna blend out really easily. But I'm just gonna go in with a light hand there, just so I don't overdo it. Shine on, diamond, don't make me wait another day. Cause passion is passion, you know it just. Okay, not as bad as I thought that was gonna be either. I do wish it was more cool tone and probably a little darker, but I do think I'm gonna use this more as like a bronzer and then go in with a different type of contour. But I'm gonna add a little bit more. That did blend out really easy. Oh my, I die every night. okay, not bad. I do think I went in a little too much with that. It is starting to look a little bit orange, but that's what happens with first impressions. You test it out, see what works, see what doesn't. So probably wouldn't go in with as much next time. I also realized I don't have the ColourPop powder, so I am going to go in with my Maybelline Fit Me in the shade Fair, because we really need to set down the face. It is very tacky and creamy. This is also going to help lighten that powder down. Now it feels like we'll be able to blend some powder on top of there, because we do have a powder blush we're going to use today. I am quickly just going to go in and contour my nose. This just helps bring some shape back to my nose. So while it's baking, I'm going to go in with my powder blush. This is actually the whole reason that I decided to place an order with ColourPop. Kathleen Lights just came out with a new pressed powder blush. Isn't this packaging cute? And I grabbed mine in the shade Lunar Has It. I haven't touched this yet, so mine is a little bit damaged, but not a big deal. This is a nice peachy, warm, neutral shade. This will be good for like an everyday kind of look. Oh yeah. Just brings back some more color to your face. Brushing off the nose powder. And I like to take my blush around over my nose, because this is where the sun is normally going to hit, is this high points of your face. So yeah, that definitely looks like a bronzer to me. It's still very pretty. Good for every day. It looks a little heavy right now, but once everything else is on our face, it's not going to look so out of place. And also, blushes typically tend to fade on me a little bit. I did also pick up the Super Shock Cheek in the shade Get Laid. Kind of want to go in with this just to kind of bring a little bit more like peachiness. Yeah, we're doing it. It's right here on the apples. Another reason I decided to go ahead and place an order is because Kathleen Lights just made her annual video of her ColourPop favorites. And when she does that, she always gets like a 20% off discount of all of her favorite products. And generally, anything Kathleen likes, I like.
I saw Katie Heron wearing army pants and flip-flops, so I bought army pants and flip-flops.
We have a very similar skin tone, so I know that anything that looks good on her is gonna look pretty good on me. And any product she's ever recommended, I've always loved. I'm just gonna blend it out a little bit. I'm going to come back to the highlight in just a little bit. I want to go ahead and start my eyes. The only new product that I grabbed for eyes is the Super Shock Shadow in the shade Waddles. I've been wanting to grab this one for years. Not because this is anything just like wham bam special, but this is like a good everyday shade to just like put all over your lid. I do also have the shade Frog. I bought this a couple months ago, but I haven't used it yet. So maybe we'll try that. Ooh. That's pretty. Another Kathleen recommendation. This video should just be called Kathleen Lights Made Me Buy It, because it's true. And I do also have a giant collection of ColourPop pressed shadows. This one is probably my favorite. This is the Kathleen Lights Dream Street palette. I feel like I need to use Frog. Okay, I decided that I am going to go in with my highlight now. I have used this one so much that the logo has came off. But this is Smoke and Whistles. And this one I have only used once. This is the shade Flexitarian. This one is very bold, whereas this one is like an everyday shade. I think I will be brave and go in with Flexitarian. Just using a little bit. This one is insane. Too much. I'm going to take the rest on this side. This one is just almost like too much for me. If you have really, really pale skin, this is going to be a great one for you because it is so white almost. Ooh. The Super Shock highlighting formula is the best. I love it. It really just melts in with your skin so easily. So what I typically do is I start right here where you'll normally have highlighter. Then I will also bring it really close to my eye here. Helps make your skin look more plump there, more youthful. Then I carry it up to my brow bone. It all ties in together. Then I bring it up here on my forehead above my brow. That way when the light hits your face, you just look really glowing, youthful, fresh. Here is the shade Flexitarian. And here is my normal go-to in Smoke and Whistles. So as you can see, this one is a lot more icy, bold, attention grabbing. This one is like your everyday type of highlighter. It really is that glow from within, makes you just look like you have healthy skin, like you got a lot of sleep. It's my favorite. We are going to go in with wattles all over the lid, just covering everything. With this formula, you can either go in with your finger or you can go in with a really dense brush. I'm going to try a dense brush. If you've never felt a Super Shock shadow, cheek, highlight, go into Ulta and try them out. They're very squishy, not like a jelly, but I don't know. It's like a little cloud. I don't know how to explain it. I'm going to go ahead and zoom you guys in just so you can see a little bit more on the eyes. Oh, too close. Okay, you're in a little closer. This is a very like mauve brownie kind of shade. It looks great just like all over the lid like that. And then I will go on with my finger on this side. These feel almost wet, very smooth. This one is a satin, so it does have like a little bit of a sheen to it. And you can see the pigment. I think the pigment is a little bit more when you go in with your finger. But I feel like the brush gives me just a little bit more control. Kathleen knows. Oh, I love it. It's got like a rosiness to it. I just love this shade. This is like a perfect shade. I'm gonna take this underneath my eyes as well. I'm just gonna use my finger to just kind of blend out the edges there. This is pretty just to like throw on your lid and just go. How long have you been out? Oh, that's annoying. I'm feeling like I wanna go in really light with the shade Elfish from the Dream Street palette. Okay, I'm just kind of tapping it on my hand because I don't want to go in too hard. I don't want to ruin everything. I'm just going to go in here on the outer corner just to give us a little bit more depth. Okay, I think I can go in a little bit more. Don't be a sissy. Okay, just makeup. So as I said, the Super Sock. Super Sock! Why do I keep saying Super Sock? Why would they name it that? Like, that's so hard to say. Super Sock Shadow. Super Shock Shadow, Super Shock, Super Duper, okay? Like I said, that Super, the Super Shock Shadow is a, like a wet formula, So it is kind of grabbing a little bit. And I'm gonna bring this on the outer corner of my lower lash line. Getting a little smoky. I'm gonna take that brush that I used for that Super Shock Shadow. Oh my gosh, I said it. And it isn't really like super blended in right there because I am gonna go in with Frog on the center of my lid. I think packing it on is a better method and then trying to blend it. Lower lash line. Ooh, sexy. Feeling sexy. And it might not necessarily be that because that Super Shock Shadow is why it might look a little patchy as much as it's because it's like a shimmer underneath. And shimmer just tends to like catch light differently than a matte shadow would. I think that's why, because I'm seeing like that shimmer come through from that Waddles shade. I'm gonna go back in with Waddles just to kind of blend that out a little bit. Why am I tapping? Okay, we're going in with Frog. I love the little quilted pattern that these have. Let's just swatch this. It has like blue and pink and rose gold shimmer to it, or I guess maybe glitter. Ooh. Mm-hmm. This. So pretty. Don't they just look wet? Okay, and the more I'm building it up, the more you can see like the colors of that shimmer coming through, like that blue, which I'm not really wanting for this look. So just gonna stop packing it and just kind of take this to blend it out a little bit and blend it in. I don't want it to look blue. This is definitely like a topper shade. I wouldn't just use it. I mean, you could use it on the lid bare, but I bet this would look really pretty on the lid all by itself and then like a gloss over top. Might have to try that. I'm gonna take this pencil brush right here and we are gonna go into the inner corners. It's not picking up super good on my pencil brush, so I'm just gonna go in with my pinky here. Okay, definitely better. I just like to be able to control it a little more. Bam! I'm gonna take this up on the brow bone again. Got a little bit lost. And this is why I like to do my brows later, because I just like to be able to mess with them however I want. Going back in with waddles. This is literally how I do my makeup. Back and forth, back and forth. I mean, if I'm in a hurry, I'm not going to, but you know, when I'm just sitting here playing with makeup, loving that, loving. I'm gonna take a little bit more powder just to kind of get rid of that shine I have from that highlighter. So I want it focused right in that inner corner, not kind of pulling my eye down. Okay, I'm gonna do my brows real quick. So if they're driving you nuts, I'll take care of it. I'm using the It Cosmetics Brow Power in the shade Universal Taupe and the Revlon Colorstay Brow Pencil in the shade Auburn. Just because this one is a little too cool tone for my eyes. For my eyebrow hair color. Now I'm finishing it up with Auburn so I can get that color in there that I want. I lose everything on my desk. Where is that foundation at? Just gonna go in with a little bit of this, clean up the front right there. When I start brushing it out, it tends to get a little wonky. I am not a professional at my brows, still learning. So if you're coming here for the Instagram brow, you're in the wrong place. You're at the wrong channel. Where are you, my favorite pencil? Where are you? I wanna use you. There you are. I'm gonna go ahead and use my favorite eyeliner. This is in the shade Mr. Bing. I'm going a little bit here on my eyelid so I can continue that smoky effect. Not making a wing or anything, and it doesn't need to be perfect because we are going to smudge it out. While we're up here, I'm going to tight line the upper lash line. And I'm going to take it on my waterline. I don't know how people do this without pulling down. Okay, I'm sorry. Pulling down. Very lightly, though. I would much rather not stab my eye. I feel like this eyeliner shade is perfect for any color eyes. It's gonna make blue eyes pop, brown eyes pop, green eyes pop. I'm going with this Wet n Wild brush and I'm just going to smoke this out. Really working that into the lash line as well. We are looking smoky, we are looking sexy. Okay. Woo! Loving it so far. Loving it all. I'm loving it. Another first impression. This is the BFF Volumizing Mascara in the shade Black on Black. This packaging feels really good. It's not as heavy as like the Too Faced Better Than Sex Mascara or some of those really high-end ones, but it's definitely got some weight to it, more so than any drugstore one I've ever felt. Feels really high quality. This brush shape reminds me a lot of the L'Oreal Lash Paradise, which is also similar to the Better Than Sex Mascara. However, that one almost has like the bristles are, I guess I'll try it and see if it's the same, but I feel like the Better Than Sex Mascara has like harder bristles, so they comb through a little easier, like not as plasticky as the L'Oreal ones. Almost forgot to curl my lashes, so curling my lashes. I always go down first so I can make sure that my lash line is really dark. It feels like a dry formula, which I actually like dry formulas more so than wet formulas. Okay, there is one coat for both lashes. Let's do another coat. Definitely voluminous. You can see that. They're almost clumpy without being like overly clumpy. It's like the right amount of clump. Like they don't look spidery and they're not like super globbing together or anything. I really like that so far. I'm going to go on the lower lash line. I think it does what it says, where it's very voluminous. It doesn't add like a lot of length. I'm not sure how it wears since this is my first time using it, so I'm not sure if it flakes or anything. That formula dries really fast, so you need to kind of work fast. And it might just take playing around with so that I can just see how the best way to wear it is. Because I did notice it was kind of drying down faster than I'm used to. With a dry formula, that's fine. And they don't feel like really hard or anything. To me, this feels like a mascara that I would probably mix with another one. And as far as I know, this isn't waterproof or anything. So I'm gonna go ahead and set my face real fast. I should have done this before I did mascara, but oh well. I'm gonna use the Wet n Wild Cucumber 3-in-1 Primer Water. I should have zoomed in also before I did this, but I am seeing a little bit of flaking there. And that could have been because I was trying to layer it while it was already kind of dry. So maybe if I worked a little faster, it wouldn't have done that. And then once this dries down, I will brush away those little flakes. I did grab two new lip colors, both in the Ultra Satin lip colors. One is Aquarius and one is Dreamy. My all-time favorite liquid lip is the Ultra Satin Lip in the shade Alyssa. I actually wore this on my wedding day, so very special to me. And then I did also receive that Atta Girl in the Ultra Glossy Lip. I'm gonna try that out. Smells like vanilla. Clear gloss with some like blue and pink shimmer to it. I like it. I'm gonna take that off and try Dreamy. Ooh, that's pretty. That is a very pretty shade. This is like a burnt salmon shade. This is my first time trying a lippy pencil, and I grabbed mine in the shade BFF. Aww, that's sad. Where'd you go? Get out of there. Well, that kind of stinks. The little tip of it just fell off. Not a big deal, but now I don't have a little pointy end. How do you use this? Do you sharpen these? Is this a twist or a sharpen? It feels like plastic, but let's try to sharpen it. Oh no, it sharpens. Okay, so it does sharpen. No big deal. Let's try that again. So just like a perfect little nude color. I grabbed this color because I figured it would go good with a lot of other lip colors I have. It's definitely got some brown in there. I love it. It reminds me a lot of Alyssa, just a little more brown. Very pretty. I do think that lip liner is a little darker than I would prefer with this lip color, but not bad. Kind of gives a nice little ombre, makes them look a little more full. I'm gonna dust away those little flakes I had going on. I love the Ultra Satin formula because it's super comfortable. It doesn't like ever dry out your lips and it kind of stays a little tacky. But it almost looks matte. So it's just like a great in-between type of formula. Okay, you guys, we just completed my very first look. What do you guys think? I really love how everything turned out. First impressions are really hard because I feel like I'm somebody who likes to play around with products and find the way that they work the best. Definitely gonna be playing around with these more. Colourpop is my all-time favorite brand and I love everything they come out with. And I know they have stuff for every single person. Someday I will be on the Colourpop PR list. You mark my words. We'll come back to this video. We'll remember. I'm really excited to see where this channel goes. I just love playing with makeup. I love telling people about the products that I like, the products that I don't like, recommending things to people. There's nothing worse than going out and spending your money on products that just aren't good, that just aren't worth your money, and it's just like burning your damn money. I really want to help people that maybe have similar taste in makeup that I do so that, you know, maybe I can test those out for you and you don't have to go spend the money. Thank you so much for watching my first video. If you guys are still here and watched it to the end, thank you so much for supporting me. If you do subscribe, please leave a comment down below. And I wanna give you a subscriber number because I wanna keep track of like my first 100, maybe my first 1,000 subscribers. I can be like, yes, you've been with me since the start, almost like a first member thing, you know? So if you do subscribe, leave a comment down below. Let me know what you think. Let me know anything I can improve on. Give me some future video ideas, things you want to see. This isn't my first video that I filmed. I already have some videos pre-filmed. I really wanted to get in the groove, maybe not be so awkward on camera. I mean, I wouldn't say I'm awkward. I feel like I'm just like goofy. I'm kind of just a goofball. I don't I don't try to take myself too serious. You know, life's too short to be just walking around all serious. Yeah, I hope you guys subscribe. Please give this video a thumbs up, and I hope to see you guys in my next video. Bye. Oh my, my, my. I die every night with you. Is anybody else hot? Is anybody else sweating? But what if they don't like me? Please like me. Please like this video.
What is this?
Oh my god. What are you saying? They don't even know what you're saying. You don't make any sense.
Get it together. Come on, Dusty.
You guys. You guys, you are witnessing the first video on my YouTube channel. Yep, I have a YouTube channel. I'm a YouTuber. What? Are you shooketh the house? I don't even know what that means, but I know that beauty gurus say that, and I'm a beauty guru now. So, now I better go get some lip injections. You are not invited here. Thank you. Why do we make this face? Don't judge. I need to color my hair. I cannot sing. Oh well. That's cute. I feel cute. Love the song.